Oh boy, here it comes. The combine so many farmers are talking about. The Twin Rotor Combine from Sperry, New Holland. Lots of people know how well it works, but up until now, you haven't heard how it does its job so well. Believe me, I'm a real expert. I know the Twin Rotor concept inside and out. Phew! The centrifugal force from those Twin Rotors really gives you a whirl. Hi, my name is T.R. for Twin Rotor, and I want to tell you about the Twin Rotor concept for combining grain, all kinds of grain. Twin Rotor combining means less grain damage, less crop loss, and a cleaner sample. Let me show you how the Twin Rotor concept and centrifugal force work. The crop comes up from the feeder housing here under these augers. See how wide the feed opening is where the crop mat divides into the two rotors? The wider the mat, the thinner it will be, and a thin mat is easier to thresh. And now the crop enters the threshing grates where all kinds of good things start happening. See these transport fins inside the rotor cover? Just like rifling in a rifle barrel, they start spiraling the crop around the rotors and toward the rear. These rasp bars start the threshing action. Notice there's only one set of rasp bars on each side of each rotor. Then these separator blades take over. They also help spiral the crop rearward. This way, the crop gets three or more gently whirling passes around the rotors instead of only one harsh abrasive action, as in a conventional combine's concave and cylinder. All the time this rotating, whirling action is going on, grain is threshed and separated from the crop mat through these grates. But even these separator grates are not the end of the line. To catch that last little bit of grain, whoops! That was the discharge beater and grate. Only Sperry New Holland has one to save valuable grain, like me, before throwing crop residue out the back. Okay, now you've seen how the crop passes through the twin rotors, but I haven't yet shown you the really important things that go on inside those tubes, like centrifugal force. Wow! Centrifugal force is a combination of speed, weight, and turning radius. And it makes all the difference between twin rotor combining and any other kind of combining, either conventional or rotary, in the field today. Let's take speed first. That's the speed the crop mat revolves around the cylinder of a conventional combine, or around the rotors in any rotary combine. There's one ideal speed for each kind of crop, and it's the same in any kind of combine. Now, weight. The weight of one kernel of grain is about the same as the one next to it at the moment of harvest, no matter which kind of combine you use. And finally, we come to turning radius. Here's the big difference between twin rotor combining and all other kinds of combines, conventional or rotary. See, the twin rotor turning radius is smaller. Maybe this will help explain why a small turning radius is so important. Both of these cars are traveling at the same speed, and they weigh the same. Watch the car on the left. Zip, off he goes. Now the car on the right. Oh, that took a long time. You get much more centrifugal force when the turning radius is small, even though both cars weigh the same and they're traveling at the same speed. It's this extra centrifugal force in the smaller diameter twin rotors that makes the grain let go much quicker.
I'm going, I'm going, I'm gone!
And that's why you get less crop loss and a cleaner grain sample, too. But there's much more to it than that. Let's talk about grain damage now. You see, a conventional combine has 8 rasp bars on its cylinder and needs every one of them to deliver a quick, harsh flailing action on grain. When it's turning, some of the grain can't get out of the way of all those rasp bars quickly enough, like a punch mulching bag, grain bounces around and gets socked many times. But a twin rotor combine has only two sets of RAS bars on each rotor, set far apart. And don't forget, the extra centrifugal force is very helpful here, too. Grain lets go quicker, so it gets out quicker through the grates with less grain damage. Centrifugal force also helps give you a cleaner grain sample. That spiraling motion puts a whirling action on both crop residue and on grain. But straw and chaff are light. You sure can't throw straw very far. But you can throw grain a long way, because it's heavier. That's why centrifugal force puts clean grain in your tank, not straw or other crop residue. Well, folks, now you know the secret of twin rotor combining and why it gives you less grain damage, less crop loss, and a cleaner sample. It's the twin rotor concept, and only sperry-new Holland has it. Because at sperry-new Holland, the main idea is making machines do more so man can do more.